Hey guys, welcome to Wake Up Missoula, coming to you between the Arch Channel. It's Wake Up Missoula with your host, Scott Ramp. We have a lot of stuff that we're going to be talking about here today on our morning show. We do our morning show every Wednesday and Friday for you guys, just kind of encompass what's going on here and around Missoula and what's affecting you and what's happening on our channel on MCAT. So what I'm going to be talking about today is the city will be discussing the Fox site and what they're going to be putting there. Here's a spoiler, it's a hotel. More news on the Montana Supreme Court decision about Mountain Water Company and the Missoula's acquisition of it. We got Pre-Critic for some of the new releases that are coming out. Teen Talk is back this Friday, like I promised on Wednesday. So we're going to see some Teen Talk as what they think about Trump as new president, and also who would be good against Trump in the future. Let's see, all the stuff happening in Missoula in terms of events, and also we have a new art clip from our very own Rick Phillips featuring at the Missoula Art Museum. But let's just jump into it and let's talk about some weather. It is cold outside, folks, but it's not too cold. It's kind of like things have kind of like gotten very moderately cold, so it's a typical winter. Things aren't too cold. It hasn't like been freezing temperatures, but it's still cold outside. It is currently 18 degrees outside. Your high today is going to be 27. It's going to be mostly sunny today, so it's not going to be too bad if you guys are out in the sun. Your low is going to be 9 degrees. Saturday, your high is going to be 22, and your low is going to be 4. Sunday, basically, you're going to have the same weather for the next couple of days throughout this time, and it's not going to be that big of a deal. It's not going to snow, but here are some of your reports on terms of what kind of slopage and what kind of snow is going to be packed up in the mountains if you guys are planning on going up skiing. So let's take a quick look. Whitefish Mountain Ski Area had 3 inches of snow in the last 72 hours. Black Mountain Ski Area had 7 inches. Big Sky Resort, no fresh new snow for a while, but their slopes are said to be open. Montana Snow Bowl, they had 2 inches of snow. Lost Trail, you haven't had any fresh snow for a while, so you may need to double check with them to make sure that things are okay, but you have a red dot, so that means that it may not be good to go up there to snow. Bridger Bowl, they had 12 inches in the last 72 hours, so that looks pretty good. I think that usually stays off if you are planning on going up skiing or snowboarding or whatnot. Trenton Pass Ski Area, they're a little warning, so you may need to double check with them as well. Maverick Mountain, they had 2 inches in the last 72 hours. Great Divide. Discovery Ski Area had 3 inches in the last 72 hours, and that's basically it. And I got that information from onthesnow.com. And you can check that out. The Montana Ski Report basically tells you all the slopes here in Montana. And I probably should have like double-checked and see Idaho, because Idaho is probably a lot closer than like, if you were going to like Red Lodge or whatever. But here are some of your here are some of your news events that are happening. Montana Supreme Court ordered in favor of Missoula in terms of handing over customer data and human resource information so the city can move forward. When the city requested the data to for the acquisition of the water company, the current owners and the current employees of Mountain Water Company refused to release customer data and their human resource, like kind of like listing of who is what and how much they get paid and stuff like that, to the city of Missoula. And they said that they had an emergency, I guess the emergency request to the Supreme Court saying this is like, you know, we don't need to release the information until we actually get the money for when Missoula actually acquires the water company. So basically, Mountain Water Company has to hand over information about customer data and their human resources to the city of Missoula, so the city of Missoula can move forward. Because that's the thing about a public utility, is that every money, everything that's going in and out of Mountain Water Company has to be public information. And since it's going from private to public ownership, that's something that that's some of the changes that people have to kind of deal with. But that I got a lot of this from the Billings Gazette, and of course a little bit from the Missoulian as well, just kind of going over what's going on with this and that. But in the nation, I thought this was pretty interesting, is that looks like Trump's promise to build a wall is actually moving forward, and America's getting stuck with a bill. So what they're proposing is like an import tax. So imagine you're at the bar, you buy yourself a drink, you walk up to a girl and just like you show her the drink and you're just like, just so you know, I want you to pay for this. That's basically what they're doing. So sometime later, you build a wall using the money, and then you make them pay for it. That's the idea. It's like, use the money that the taxpayers make, that the taxpayers pay to make the wall, and then you just send them a bill, and you know, you expect them to pay. It's according to Trump spokesman Sean Spicer, the import tax would work, but he said it could be adopted as part of a comprehensive tax reform after the idea sparked controversy. Spicer later walked back the idea, saying that it could be a multitude of things. The tax could be 20%, 18%, or 5%, he said, adding that he wasn't trying to be prescriptive. No taxation without representation in America, but there was nothing said about taxing other countries for some reason. Mexico's refusal to pay for this wall has already created friction between the two countries. Mexican President Enrique Peña Nieto abruptly canceled a planned meeting with Trump next week, a decision that U.S. President Trump says was mutual. Sean Spicer also said that, "I think we're going to save additional money that we would have to spend on tracking down illegal immigrants and on immigration." So it's actually a huge win for America, taxpayers, for American security, when you look at the kind of plan that's coming to fruition right now, end quote. Import tax basically means, can't somebody else do it? No. No one's going to pay your taxes for you. And I got this information from NPR. And I just want to let the record show that I don't hate Trump personally, but I also never really liked Obama. It's like politicians. You know, you never really like them. You don't like the politics. You know, you like a government that kind of works. And I also hate the government that the media portrays, for sure. But that's all you guys need to know about what's happening in the news today. Here's a nice little taste of what's going to be new on AMCAT this weekend.
So another humanities program that we've been doing lately is the 100th anniversary of the Pulitzer Prize, and so all through the spring and in the fall, I think, as well. And I don't know if there's summer programs going on as well here in Missoula, but Missoula and Billings are putting on a series of free events to the public. We just finished one this past Wednesday about on the poetry of Galway Canal, and we had Crystal A. Pacini dancing and Parker Brown on bass, and I did the poetry of Galway Canal, and we had just a packed house. It was wonderful. And so Galway was my teacher at NYU when I was in graduate school there, and sort of a mentor to me, but a mentor to so many other people. So I claim no special privilege with that, except that he left a deep impression. So we had just did a poem of Galway's, so we're going to do a poem of Galway's, and I think it'll be wonderful. At least it's one of my favorite ones. It's one of those, whenever I hear his work, especially when I read it out loud, it's almost like you're listening to poetry and suddenly you get silent as a reader, and then you can feel the sound of the poem going down and up just at the same time, and it just you're getting vertical with it while you're just staying. It's an amazing thing for me to listen to his work.
And there are two qualifications to do that. It needs to be a planned gift, and I'll explain what that is, made to an endowment. Now, why isn't it just a direct gift? Actually, when the law was written in 1997, it was a direct gift. But nonprofits were really worried that people would just do this, and then they wouldn't have any annual operating funds. So the legislature and the people that lobbied for this changed it to a planned gift to make it a little bit more complicated. But the endowment part had always been there. Why did this even come about? Because in the mid-90s, we discovered that in Montana, we again were last at something. We were the last in philanthropic funds in the United States, in endowed philanthropic funds in the United States.
So transportation access is kind of, it's ubiquitous. So in this environment, what determines local success? And in all places, local success is a function of capacity. Capacity is a function of your natural capital, your physical capital, your human capital, and your social capital. And those last two, human capital, the knowledge and skills of your workers, and your social capital, the relationships amongst people and the institutions and norms that govern those relationships, have become far, far more important. So if you look at what's growing in the American economy today, we call it job market polarization. So over the past 25 years, we've seen about 70% growth in knowledge work. So CEOs and lawyers and doctors and teachers and software developers and all that kind of stuff, college educated work, the stuff you kind of think about, that stuff has grown substantially. We've also seen growth at the bottom end, like low skill service work, grown by almost as much. But if you're a production worker or you're a sales and office worker, literally no net job creation from 25 years, probably 35 years actually went back. So this has clear implications for regional economies. Places that can harness knowledge work, create knowledge products, those are places that are more primed to survive because there's less work to be done in these natural resource industries, more work to be done in these knowledge industries.
Welcome back, guys. I got a couple announcements from MCAT. So if you want more information, that's some new programming that's happening on MCAT. And if you want more information, you can go to, let's see, just making sure my audio is working. You can go to MCAT.org and find out more information about how you can be part of MCAT and have MCAT come out and shoot for you guys. But of course, we also have trainings and things happening here at MCAT for you guys to come on down and be a part of. And for one instance, we just recently just got a brand new camera. So it's really nice that we're going to be streaming with this kind of camera. It's a Sony camera. Let's see if I can quickly turn it on just for you guys to kind of display some cool little tech stuff that's happening here at MCAT. This is the camera we're going to be using for live streaming. As you can see, a nice little Sony camera. You know, you have your card slot. It's just some really sweet brand new tech that we just got. You know, nice little handle. It's really solid, and it's a nice little heft to it as well. And it came with a nice little remote, so you can actually attach a little remote to it and have it down to your tripod and act as it like a studio camera. And so this is the point I'm showing you this is that this is the kind of camera we're going to be using for live streams at MCAT. So any future sports, any kind of thing that we're going to be live streaming, this is going to be like kind of like the main live stream camera. It has a 24 times optical zoom. I think it's just amazing. Great product by Sony. And the good kicker about it is that it has a nice little SDI out. Let's see, I can't really show it. Ugh. See, this is SDI out. The whole concept of SDI out is that now we're able to hook it directly to our cellular bonding streaming device. So if we just want a single camera to do for our one shoot and whatnot, we can hook this camera up by itself. We hook up a nice little audio line to these plugs right here, boost up the audio if we need to with the nice little knobs here, just kind of turn up the volume and whatnot. And yeah, we're pretty much good to go with anything that's live streaming. And that's a nice little new camera that I just kind of wanted to show you guys that MCAT just got for media assistant grants, kind of like what you just saw there. It'll basically overall improve our look and our feel of what MCAT's going to be doing. And you can find out more information by logging on to, again, MCAT.org. And you could always find out more information about my morning show by logging on to wakeupmissoula.com. .wixsite.com/wakeupmissoula. You can always Google and all that stuff. I've been doing I have a tendency to choose the hokey pictures of me just having like sass face. So just look at me doing sass face. I implore you guys, check out some of the other videos as well, see more sassy faces. You can see past interviews. Again, tomorrow morning, all day, Julie Richter came on our show. She talked about the Business Women's Network Symposium. You guys can totally check that out. I'll talk a little bit more about that in events later on in the show. But here is a nice brand new art clip for you guys featuring the art museum. And this is going to end in May, on May 13th. So it's going to be there for a while, but I'm just going to give you a little tease. And then I'm going to show you the art auction a little bit later in the show, just before I do events. So I'll be back with some pre-critic stuff, just kind of prejudging movies before I even actually know anything about them. ¶¶ Okay, once again, I want to thank our very own Rick Phillips, who goes out and shoots all our little art pieces. It's just little art teases. We get a grant from a foundation that promotes art and stuff like that. So we want to thank, once again, Rick for providing us with some great content such as that. A couple art openings and art gallery openings are happening at the University of Montana this weekend and today, so you guys can totally check out those as well. But now it's time for a little segment I like to call It's called Pre-Critic. Matthew McConaughey basically shaves himself to make him look like he's balding, that kind of thing. And he made this movie. And from the guy who thought one Oscar isn't enough comes a movie that kind of hits the nail on the run for an Oscar movie. Being a classical style musical with good looking people talking about jazz and alley or whatever. It's a bunch of white people talking about jazz. Anyways, this movie is kind of on the nose with the title, Gold. Come see a movie about a guy who's looking for gold in a period piece that's based on a true story. Based on a true story are one of my favorite words that people like to use, and especially the studio likes to use. So they basically have a little tidbit of information about the story, and they can basically make up anything about the movie without making an effort on the true part. So, hey, you want to make a movie about Lewis and Clark's exploration? They travel the cosmos with Zoe Saldana and red-skinned alien showing them their way. It's based on a true story about Lewis and Clark. It's in space. It's totally based on a true. I swear, it's based on a true story. Moving on, we got A Dog's Purpose. From sad animal movies like Homeward Bound comes A Dog's Purpose. It's kind of like putting a lot into other actors to propel this movie without staying on one particular person. You know, I'm bored of watching this teenager in the beginning part of the movie. Let's change the channel. Here's some dog with a new group of humans. Oh, it's a cop. Oh, he's in an abusive relationship with another animal. It's basically a dog with reincarnation powers. And it's not really, it's just kind of like, you know, it's at one point, another point, and it's also based on a book. So that's another thing that studios do, is like, it's based on a book. Doesn't mean it's word for word. So, okay, basically, let's bring him home to the beginning, because when a movie starts a film, they usually end the film in the same place where they started. Just think about it. They really do. Moving up, we got from this series that has never really stopped, both in video games and in movies, comes Resident Evil, The Final Chapter. As if making video games into movies didn't really work, now it continues to kind of not work. The last movie was fairly successful. Well, it made more money than it lost, so that's why they can justify making more movies like this. Okay, anyways, this is an excuse for the studio to have a going out of business sale for a couple more movies. I bet the next movie is called Resident Evil Origins. It's a popcorn movie that's getting released about this time, because better movies are on the horizon. But hey, would you rather see an Oscar bait movie, cute animal movie, or like a nice action-y popcorn movie where you get to shoot zombies and like flying alien creature zombie things? You could always now watch the movie. But of course, that concludes Pre-Critic. Thank you guys for joining me for this. But of course, I have a nice little brand new teen talk for you guys. It is featuring how the teens have reacted to Donald John Trump.
I'm Neil Wells, and this is Teen Talk. Welcome back. Today on Teen Talk, President Trump, and who would do well against him? So, we have Owen, Jackson, and Liam returning again. So, let's start with you, Liam. How do you feel about the very new President Trump?
Let's see.
Do you have any thoughts, Jackson?
Woo.
Why America?
Is that it?
That's it.
Ellen?
Why must you do this, America? You just totally stole that from me.
So, how do we feel about new policies? Do you have any thoughts with that?
Well, with the thing you were talking about with the
pipeline
thing?
The Dakota Access Pipeline?
Yeah. That sucks.
It sucks for who?
Me. The people.
Carry it out a little bit, man.
I don't know. I just heard about it 2 minutes ago.
All right, Jackson?
I think that the pipeline does kind of suck for like people that oppose it, mainly like just where it's going. Just sounds like the classic white man invade native territory and stuff like that. Was that racist?
Yes, it was.
No. All right. We'll fix that in post.
Owen, how do you feel about Trump's new executive orders?
Pretty much the same. I don't like
Ryan Zinke for the cabinet or whatever the heck it was.
I don't like them, don't just like everybody else.
I don't support Ryan Zinke. That was a joke.
All right.
Get the duct tape for him.
Now we're going to be talking about who we think would make good competitors for Trump in the next election. So why don't we start with you, Owen?
Don't call on me.
I don't really have anybody, so Jackson.
Here, let me start by throwing out some names.
Yes, okay. Please.
All right, Liam. Do you think Biden would make a good candidate to beat Trump next election?
I don't know. Probably better. Yeah, I guess.
All right, Jackson.
Probably.
Yeah.
Do you think there's anybody who would make a good opponent for Trump?
Not Kanye.
Not Kanye. <Yeah. laughs> Well, at least it's an answer.
Yeah. Well, how about you the same thing? Can you do the same thing with me? Throw some names out there.
Okay. So why don't we throw out Gary Johnson.
I don't know who that is.
He was the Libertarian candidate in this last election.
Oh. Yeah, he seemed okay. I mean, he wasn't Kanye, and he wasn't Trump. So, yeah, that's better than that.
That's pretty much what this all...
Owen's turn!
...sums up to you.
Who? I'm going to say Garfield.
Garfield!
Garfield. Oh, if we're doing cartoon characters, I say Dilbert.
Take Dilbert, that. Dilbert!
Or Jason Fox.
Some experience there, yeah.
Jason Fox.
Liam?
President.
I don't watch cartoons.
No,
and
this
stuff.
Is like the comic strips in the newspaper.
I don't do that either.
You don't read the comic strips?
Luann.
Okay, I've read like Peanuts and stuff.
Okay. Which Peanut would make the best competitor for Trump?
What about the old dude from Pickles?
You mean Earl?
Yeah, he seems pretty good.
Probably
Linus? Is that a Linus or was that a pig pen?
No, neither.
Have you seen the Family Guy where Charlie
Snoopy?
Brown comes back?
Snoopy for president, 2020.
Snoopy.
Liam's opinion.
With the Vice President Woodstock.
Opinion. Vice VP Woodstock. Yes. I think we're setting up quite the dream team here.
Uh-huh. We got Luann as head of the EPA and President Snoopy and VP Woodstock and. Secretary of Defense Dilbert. What's Dilbert's last name?
That's a good question.
Dilbert Classified. Okay.
All right.
Next topic? Yeah. Right?
That was our second topic.
Oh, wait, really?
Yeah.
Oh, we'll fix that in post.
See ya.
So I think that about wraps up this episode. I'm Neil Wells. This is Teen Talk. Thanks for watching.
That's Neil Wells.
Neil Wells.
Neil Wells.
Hey guys, welcome back. The city of Missoula is going to the hotel business. The Fox Hotel is building, and the city of Missoula is having a stake in the building in the form of the conference center that's going to be inside a 200-room hotel. Here's the here's our mayor, Mayor John Engen, kind of discussing about how he feels about it's about time that this Fox site is being developed.
We have been talking about this site for a very long time, and Mr. Bean will tell you that we actually began talking about this site when dinosaurs roamed the earth. He has been hard at it for these many years, and since Missoula City Council entered into an agreement with Fox Hotel Partners, we have gone through many iterations trying to get where we are today, and that is to have a proposal that this council can consider that will lift all boats. We have long talked about doing something great at this site. It is unique. It is a place unlike others around the country, and in fact, it's a place where it's a place that many communities try to recreate artificially. We don't have to do that here, and that is a gift, and we want to make sure that we take full advantage of that gift. And we think that this proposal was an acknowledgement of that gift, and that this development agreement in its current form allows us to move forward in a dramatic way on that site that will benefit the community for a long time to come.
All right. So again, they were talking about the Fox site, and if you don't know what the Fox site is, you're crazy, then you're not from Missoula. Anyways, the Fox site is between Taco John's and all the way up to the Orange Street. About there, I would say probably a little further up, because there's a couple other sites there. During the meeting, they refer to different spots of the area. There's the Fox site, there's a chicken site which the St. Pat's Hospital owns, and then there's a little hut or hen house or something that they own as well. So it's kind of like it's a ranch. They call it the ranch, the chicken, and the Fox site. So it's kind of like in the same kind of area. The Fox site is the one that's going to be developed into that hotel that they're talking about. Financial implications. So you guys want to know how much this is going to cost? The Fox site agreements sets the basic terms for several other required agreements to be negotiated. Those agreements include TIF and parking revenue financing that and be approved by the city council. They'll be building a hotel, and the city is getting a conference center with over 29,000 square feet for a bigger venue to take place. They're going to be selling the property for $2.3 million to the hotel. While also at the same time, the hotel company will build the conference center for Missoula, but Missoula have to maintain and run that conference center. That's kind of like the agreement that they're working with Fox, Hotel Fox. And here is another thing. This is Chris Bean, and he is from M&R. He gave a little bit of a history lesson on what it's all about. Here is Chris.
Years and 9 months ago was the Fox. And we had just finished RFP number one, and I was supposed to put together RFP number two. Well, there's been a total of seven, and this is the last one. The vision, since the Fox site was actually given to the city, and then we purchased some other property later on, has always been, has been consistent through all that time, that the uses and the size of the whatever goes there should maximize change in the downtown and maximize the economic benefit to the entire community. But it that recognizes that it's probably going to be instigated and developed by the private sector to be able to do that. Second, that whatever goes there is a product of excellence in design, superior design, and finally, that the spinoff to the rest of the property in that area and a little bit further into the greater downtown are exercised, so that this will actually help develop that.
All right. So, again, that was Chris Bean, and he says that by building this hotel conference center, it will help elevate the city of Missoula. Hotel Fox will be building on the site that reflects the best of having a public-private public/private partnership that benefits the Missoula downtown area while also taxing them as well during the tax increment fund. The city and Hotel Fox LLC have now wrote up a memorandum of understanding, sorry, which since the city owns the land that the Fox Hotel is building, the hotel will basically pay off the land to a certain amount of totaling $2.3 million. It's a way for them to pay for the land over time rather than going through like a bank all at once without like worrying about like certain interest. I'm assuming the city will have some kind of interesting planned, but it's just basically money directly. It's like for sale by owner, which explains why it took quite a long time to find a buyer, because it was the city of Missoula. They're really looking for like a solid person who would kind of actually do this, put their stake in with Missoula to work with this conference center. And also they talked a little bit about parking. I think the one thing, it's going to be a 200 unit hotel. I'll talk a little bit more about parking, but they're going to have twice as many parking spots as they will have hotel rooms. So that's going to hopefully help alleviate some parking as well, and they'll have some residential type of building as well that going to be there. It's not going to just be like a hotel. They'll also have residents as well. Brian von Lossberg, let's see. Yep, that's right. Brian von Lossberg talks on concerns about maintenance and capital improvements, since the city will have a stake in just kind of like the conference area. And he wants to help clarify the importance of what the $2.3 million will do for the future of the site.
More work so that we have a sense of what that pool of money needs to be. There's plenty of examples out there across the country for us to get a good idea of what, you know, for X square footage of space, what sort of fund balance should we have so that we know that we're in good shape, you know, going forward. So I just wanted to add that element of context. Appreciate the work that's been done on this so far. But as Emily said, it's more than just making sure that we don't, you know, net out at zero the 2.3. We certainly wouldn't want to do that. But more importantly, we want to make sure that we're indeed leaving a sufficient balance there, or that we're aware of a gap that may exist there so that we're planning for it going forward. So there's not really a question in there. I just wanted to add that context.
All right. So that was Brian von Lossberg kind of explaining a little bit more about what the money would definitely bring for into the city. I just threw in a bunch of words in that sentence. The city will manage the conference center. That will be part of the Hotel Fox. Chris Bean talks about the Fox site, what folks hope to do in the future.
Time. There's several lawyers from both sides working on exactly those kind of considerations, and that's why this, not only the construction of this, which would be a fairly standard TIF agreement, TIF development agreement, that would come to you because it would be bonded, but there's also a management agreement that has to get put together that would have to address the exact default and remedy systems that you're talking about right there, and they're working through those right now. But the intent would be that the city, that certainly would be the last resort, or I can't imagine that what we're trying to do is to make sure that that's a near impossible thing, that we'd end up trying to ask the Parks Department or whoever else to try to run a conference center. We're not capable of that, nor should we probably get into that. So we would have to hire a different manager. I mean, the complete fallback would be that we would have to go out and hire a manager to run that for us, like the standard model across the country is exactly that. In this case, we'll have a closer relationship.
All right, so basically the running and maintenance of the thing will be put on by the city. The city will hire. It's like a public utility in a way. So they'll treat it like a public utility. So they'll find folks. You just have the city as your boss instead of Hotel Fox. It's interesting for sure. If you're going to have this kind of partnership, you're going to be in the same building as Hotel Fox. So you might listen to the people who own the Fox, while at the same time listen to the folks at the city of Missoula. So it's kind of an interesting thing about who tells you what to do if you apply for the management position of the Hotel Fox Conference Center. All right, moving on, we got And the last quote I'm going to, oh, darn it. I keep on deleting it. here is, the city will manage the conference center as part of the Hotel Fox. No, I'm way ahead of myself. So, of course, with a potential residential area in the back back of developers' heads, like pretty far back. It's not a big thing, but it's a kind of an idea that they're working on with. The site is moving forward, and this is kind of like Crispian's last words before I wrap up your city council report.
Where there is a variety of kinds of income levels, variety of kinds of uses, perhaps ground floor retail and that sort of thing. So, you know, that's their general interest. They're just going to have to get to that point and figure out what they can do. And I suspect that, although it probably doesn't work in this agreement because that's so far down the line, that there will be more opportunities, that there will be more assistance required and more opportunities for input into that, as well as the other blocks.
All right, so that basically... Basically, he just said what I was going to tell you guys. sorry about that, guys. I did this last night. It's kind of like kind of went over it. So here are the bare bones of it. The city of Missoula is going to be selling their $2.3 million Fox site land to the Fox Hotel. It's interesting, the names. Anyway, they're going to be building a hotel. And part of this will be a conference center and parking, which any parking that's happening in downtown Missoula will be run through the Parking Commission. So they'll be talking more about that a little bit later. They just want to have the a right amount of parking to match the amount of units that will be put into the hotel. And also, this is just kind of like the beginning step of having basic riverside apartment residential kind of like areas. The first thing that will be built will be the hotel conference center. That's kind of like their phase one. But then they'll see what kind of opportunities arise when they attempt to sell the chicken and ranch site, which is technically just adjacent to the Fox site. They talked about this during the meeting. You can find out more information by going on to ci.missoula.mt.us. It's a nice little website where you guys can find out everything that's going on with the city, events, parks and rec, fun stuff that are happening. You go to your government. I always go to Agenda Webcasts and Minutes under City Council because I'm looking for some City Council stuff. You click on it. It'll bring you to a nice little page right here. And just wait a couple seconds because it always has to load because it has to load the most recent meetings that were posted there. And as you can see, here are all the meetings. And if you see MP3, MP4, let me just zoom in a little bit more on this. And if you see an MP3, MP4, you guys can either listen to it, watch it, and also you can watch and see it through your agenda as well. Here, this is I just click on agenda. It brings us up. You can see an agenda. You click on any of those links, and it brings you to a certain point in the meeting. So if they're talking about a rezoning thing, I usually just kind of skip out on that because it's just rezoning. They're not really – they're just talking about, oh, this place needs more land. That's not really something that really impacts Missoula that much. A certain growth of a certain ward or certain area that they want to do. But when they talk about something like big projects that are going to be affecting Missoula, that's something I just kind of like want to relay to you guys. And this is the admin and finance meeting that was going on. There were a couple other meetings that were happening, but they weren't really talking about something that I felt that I needed to talk about. But of course, you guys are more than welcome to go on to ci.missoula.mt.us. You can Google City of Missoula to find out more information. All right, we got another art clip for you guys. And of course, I've been showing you this art clip for the last couple shows, and it's all kind of highlighting the art auction. It's called Art of the Auction, and it's going to be happening at the Missoula Art Museum. It's actually going to happen at the UC Ballroom. Tickets are like $50, $50, $75, $100 for these tickets to go to the auction. You can also bid online for some of the art pieces as well. Laura Millen, she came on to Missoula Live, which runs pretty much every single day. At about 4 o'clock here on MCAT channel 190. You guys can check that out online. MCAT Television, our YouTube channel. Subscribe to MCAT Television. You can also subscribe to Wake Up Missoula, where I post a bunch of this video, which kind of encompasses what's going on with Missoula and MCAT as well as a whole. But without further ado, here is a new art clip. And when we come back, I'll do some events for you guys, and we'll wrap up the show. To see any upcoming art installation at the Missoula Art Museum, you go to missoulaartmuseum.org for more information. Up next, we got everything you need to know about what's happening in Missoula, as soon as I bring it up. You got Project Homeless Connect happening this morning at the Missoula County Fairgrounds. It's a one-step event that builds connections, community, and hope for individuals and families experience homelessness or at risk of homelessness. Because a lot of times, it's all about missing that one paycheck. If you're living paycheck to paycheck and you miss a paycheck, that could result in disaster for some families. And this is a free service. Info includes medical costs, dental care, eye care, housing information, disability services, IDs, birth certificates, veteran information, because they're really good about helping veterans as well, senior services, mental health and addiction recovery, financial education, employment, clothing, haircuts, legal services, pet food supplies, vaccinations. And it was really interesting because United Way and the Pavarella Center, and also there's a couple other organizations as well that are being a part of this, but you can totally check that out. You can follow them on their Facebook page. It's Project Homeless Connect. They just started an event on Facebook. You guys can check it out for more information about who's involved. But I know for a fact that the Paul Varela Center and Missoula United Way came on to Missoula Live to talk more about this. And I think the really cool thing about it is, like, they have haircuts and stuff to help, like, clean up certain folks who otherwise would be turned away if they walk into certain buildings. There's a planetarium show happening tonight at the University of Montana. Join them for their show of the spring semester. The shows are at 6:30 p.m. and 8 p.m. Tickets are $6 for adults, $5 for children, and 12 and under. Tickets must be purchased in advance. And Eventbrite tickets are not sold at the door. Okay, then. Missoula Symphony Orchestra's annual family concert is going to be at the University of Montana tonight at 7 p.m. You guys can check that out. The Missoula Symphony Orchestra and music director Darko Buderetz presents the annual family concert, Rumble in the Jungle, featuring Peter and the Wolf and other legends, January 27th at 7 p.m. in the Denison Theater on UM campus. For tickets and more information, you go to missoulasymphony.org. You can call them at 721-3194. Again, that's 721-3194. Or stop by the office. It's at 320 East Main Street. You can't miss it. It's I love the symphony. The Missoula Symphony Orchestra is great. It's just wonderful. I mean, you just go see them. They sound amazing. They always have summer concerts in Karis Park, but most of the time they have them in the UM Denison Theater, and it's just crazy how amazing all of them are. Here are some of your, let's see here, Missoula Public Library events happening starting this morning. That's Tiny Tales at the Missoula Public Library at 10:30 a.m. Little kids get to hang around, do some story time. Family story time is a completely different one. It's more of an older, but they're still really young kids for family story time at the Missoula Public Library. Yarns at the Missoula Public Library, so you get to learn how to knit and crochet. This is at 12 noon today at the Missoula Public Library. This is all happening at the Missoula Public Library today. Watercolor painting class, I bet it's with Rob P. Teen Writers Group is at the Missoula Public Library at 3:30 this afternoon. Tonight with your music events, you got Mandela Effect at Imagination Brewing Company. Jeff Lake will be at Missoula Brewing Company, Highlander Tap Room. Live music with Larry Hirschberg will be at Ten Spoon Vineyard Winery. Missoula Symphony Orchestra, again, is going to be tonight at 7 p.m. Gooseberries, War Pony, and the Pool Boys is going to be at VFW tonight at 9 p.m. Let's see, Back to Skipping School is going to be tonight at the Badlander. Joan Zen is going to be at the Union Club. And the Sweet Lilies is going to be at the Top Hat tonight. And it's going to be folk music. Here are some of your Saturday events that I'm going to be highlighting. So the Missoula Business Women's Network Symposium, as Julie Richter told you guys on Wednesday for the morning show, Real Women, Montana Strong is the year's theme for the MBN Women's Symposium. Come join them at the Hilton Guardian Saturday, January 28th, this Saturday, tomorrow, 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. There will be breakout sessions with topics pertaining to business skills, health and wellness, and motivation and inspiration. To find out more information, you can go to symposium at discovermbn.com. Again, that's symposium at discovermbn.com. discovermbm.com. So you can type in discovermbn.com to find out more information about the symposium and find out all the links to get involved as well. And men are also encouraged to come join us as well, because it's Business Women's Network. Doesn't mean if you're a man trying to start a business for women, this would also be good for you as well. Volunteer income tax assistance. The University of Montana IRS certified volunteers will provide free basic tax return preparation and e-filing to eligible individuals who make less than $54,000 a year. The VITA program will take place at the University of Montana's Gallagher Business Building, room 209, tomorrow, and it's going to be from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m., and you can visit irs.gov to search VITA, it's V-I-T-A, to find eligibility criteria, as well as a list of information to bring along, including photo ID and social security cards for you, your spouse, and dependents. Frost Fever is happening at McCormick Park. The Parks and Recreation are doing an epic day of all things Frozen, except for the musical. Several events make up this action-packed day. The Frozen Fever 5K and the 1 Mile Fun Run kicks off this year's Winter Festival, and it's also held Saturday is in Broomball Tourney and Frost Fever Fulf Tournament. Sorry about that. And you can visit MissoulaParks.org, or you can call 721-PARK for more information. Bear Bait Dance presents Kinetoscope. Yeah, Kinetoscope Film Festival. And it's Bear Bait Dance partners with the Roxy Theater to bring inspiration and collaboration of dance, film to Montana. 20 unique choreographic voices and directorial visions will share the two the screening during the first final weekend in January. The artful collaboration called Screen Dancers allowed choreographers to dream big and limitations of a live stage. So the idea is, I think they're going to mix some multimedia with some live dance as well. It's happening January 28th to tomorrow at 4 p.m. and then 6 p.m. And then, of course, on Sunday, 4 p.m. and 6 p.m. So the idea is it's going to be screening A, and then screening B, then A. Different types of screening, different kind of things going on there. It's $10 per showing, $15 for both, and it's suitable for all ages. Here are some of your Saturday events happening at the public library. Five Valleys Seed Library annual seed swap. So if you're interested in starting some gardening and some things, some people planted some plants in the last couple of years, grew some plants and saved some of their seeds. You can do a seed swap that happening at 10 a.m. tomorrow. Family Story Time is at the Missoula Public Library at 11 a.m. That's pretty much it for your library events. They mostly do it during the weekdays for little kids, but their Saturday events are pretty slow. At the Top House will be an acoustic music will be playing at the Missoula Brewing Company at Highlander Tap Room. Canta Brazil will be at the Imagination Brewing Company at 6 p.m. tomorrow. Goner's UK Malt Liquor Shots will be at the VFW tomorrow night at 9 p.m. Recoil with a K, not a C, will be at the Monks. It's electronic music. Absolutely with Chris Moon will be at the Badlander tomorrow night. And Off Into the Woods will be at the Top Hat. It's going to be a reggae music rock band happening tomorrow night. And I'm probably going to go see that because I like reggae funk. I'm not into the whole folk scene because Missoula had like a huge folk scene last couple of years or so. And it's good that it's dying. No offense to folk music. But yeah, offense to folk music. So that concludes your events for you guys. Once again, I'm excited that MCAT got some new equipment so we can start doing some. We're going to be using Wirecast to live stream a lot of our events as well in the future. We got a nice little Sony cams for use for any megs or any future upcoming shoots that MCAT will be doing. I'm going to be doing the community lecture series started in February, so I'll be talking a little bit more about what community lecture series is all about. They invite folks and they usually have a theme every year. I don't know too much about it, but I'll tell you more about it as I learn more about it. And it's going to be every single Tuesday night at 7 p.m. And I believe it'll be at various places, but I'm pretty sure it's going to be at the UC Theater in the University Center at the University of Montana. So without further ado, I want to thank you all for joining me this wonderful morning. It's Friday and it's time to like unwind, just kind of like get into it. It's Friday. great weekend. And if you guys have any kids from age 9 to 13, we have our stop animation drop-in on Saturdays. We do it from 1 to 5 p.m. every single Saturday until Memorial Day. That's kind of like how we just kind of cut it off. And then we're going to be really grilling for our summer camps, which will be starting in June and going all the way through August. So we're basically going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're going to have 5 weeks of summer camps this summer at Missoula Community Access Television. To inquire and find out more information about that and also be a part of MCAT, you can call us at 542-6228, otherwise known as 542-MCAT. But if you're too scared to call us, you can email us, mcat@mcat.org, to find out more information about us. You can like us on Facebook. You can follow us on Twitter. Subscribe to us on YouTube and more. Thank you, guys. This is Wake Up Missoula. Mm-hmm.